Yeah, I know it's out of focus, but can't believe he even clicked on my link. Alright, so watch out for this stuff. So here's what I'm working on. Test car, okay? Just a test car. Ain't got but a puny bit of green left. But we're going to talk about this guy today. Oh no, where'd it go? Ah. Alright, so it's right here. It's nice and shiny, like the vet was. And of course, it was kind of old and beat up. So I had to use a few things to get it smoothed out, because like I said, it was pretty banged up. The first thing I used, I got this grinding wheel out to get all the rough spots off. You know, I'm pinned for 10,000 grinding wheel. I don't care if it says Metablo. Alright, so then we got the rough spots taken out. Alright. Then we use this damn sanding wheel. That smoothed it out really damn good. Yeah. That works pretty good. I don't know how they embed all this stuff in them damn pieces of plastic. But it worked pretty good. Alright, so then, alright, so we're down two levels now. We're getting down to the nitty gritty there. Then I had to buff it up using this wire grinder here. Yep. Took a few passes on this. And it got pretty smooth. It worked pretty good. And then we got this heavy-duty Scotch-Brite whipping wheel. Yeah. And it worked pretty good. So, what's the outcome? Well, outcome's right there. And I think, at first, I used a rock just to get all the rough spots off. Yeah. A smooth rock. You don't want just any rock. You want a smooth rock. So here's this 1974, supposedly. I really don't know what year it is. But this is the outcome. Hey! Let's zoom in on that puppy. Oh, too much. That's pretty dang cool. Well, I'm going to touch it. Look how that came out. Now, there are some pits in the roof still. I mean, the grinding wheel, I couldn't get it all out with this. So, or I'd have no roof left. You know. So, you can only do so much with this. But the rest came out pretty damn good. And then sanding it worked pretty good too. Alright, so the only thing I had left was my bandsaw, which I don't know. I got all the dings and knots out of it. And I got my brass brush. So, yeah, if you can see, there's some pits on there. Little pits. Which I'm sure if I use the silver undercoat like I'm supposed to before I do any of these enamel colors, and then sand it with 2000, I'm sure it'll cover that up. Oh, I could, which I don't want to. I could use this to take care of that. That's 99.9% pure nickel. And as you can see, I've used it a lot. And that's in this solution over here. Hang on a minute. No, it's not glazed pecans. This is nickel. Nickel electroplating solution. I've had some video. Wow, look, you can see through that. Well, it looks better already. Yeah, no. Bullshit. I could do the nickel plating. This is hard stuff, man. I mean, this is hard. But it looks so pretty right now, man. It looks so pretty. It's just those little pits in the front. Now, the Corvette had pits on the roof, too. And they're almost gone. Man, this is just beautiful. Oh, man. It got a little heavy. The spray was really strong. I mean, it was like 60 PSI. Holy crap. So the front got a little darker and the back. Anywhere the paint could sit and sag, it sat and sagged. I got a wheel alignment to an axle tool on the way to try to straighten these out. That's just going to go in the box. So, and probably same with this guy. But those axles are pretty straight. I got some more on the way. And I got some more of these. I got a 1975. Yeah, these two were my favorite cards growing up, man. First was a Corvette, and then I got, you know, smaller and faster with a 280ZX. I think this is a 240. It doesn't say, it just says Z-Wiz. But yeah, that and the Opel, the Dodge Opel, which was actually a piece of crap. But yeah, look at that. So what do you think? Should I paint it as is? I've got more paint on the way. And hardener. And the axle alignment tool. But these are not actual red lines. So it doesn't work the way they advertise. It's not going to. So what do you say? Should I hook up the battery? Drop this in there, put that in there, and then polish her back up. That'll fill in those pits. But it might be discolored, as I have to polish this off a lot. And then the rest, I don't know. I think it's going to be fine the way it is. But I like this electroplating process. It's pretty damn transforming. Yeah, we're gonna cover this back up and then we're gonna put the hell is that stuff called for fingernails? 100%. Well, I can't remember a damn thing right now. But it's to remove fingernail polish or paint. Or anything else you want to take off. But that's where we're at. So, here, let me play you something. We got this thing over here. There we go. Oh, I see them. I really think, after talking to RSI, Sean over there, you know, we're going with these, but I'm going to go with the dark green. This dark green. I'm tired of thinking around, dude. just to get it to your back door. I love these paints. Now that's maybe a little darker green than that. I'm thinking a black with a hint of green. So that's 2 drops to 10 plus 2 extra drops. Two drops black for 10 drops green plus 2 extra. I think we're going to 3 black, 10 green. It's going to come out awesome, and you know. And there's not even a clear coat on this. All right. So, that's how I polish stuff up around here. You know. All right. Have a good night. Take care.